And we begin with breaking news. The Federal Reserve moments away now from a major interest rate hike.
Our next guest's latest piece points to the Fed interest rate challenge. Rate cuts are now a matter of if, not just when.
In the constantly changing world of global finance, there is growing concern about the Federal Reserve's decision to raise interest rates. Initially, this decision was seen as a necessary step to fight inflation, but now it is causing anxiety that could destabilize the economy. This decision had a ripple effect throughout the markets, leading to a mass exodus of billionaires and institutional investors who fear that the economy is about to take a hit. In fact, the economy is being pushed to its limits, and a severe recession is imminent. This raises concerns about the effects of the Fed's interest rate hike, its impact on the economy, and the general state of economic affairs. Understanding the impact of Fed interest rate hikes. There is a lot of speculation and concern about the possibility of the Federal Reserve increasing interest rates and its impacts on the economy. To understand the situation, it's important to know that the Federal Reserve, or the Fed, adjusts interest rates to manage economic growth and inflation. When they raise rates, their aim is to prevent the economy from overheating by curbing inflation. On the other hand, when they lower rates, borrowing and spending are stimulated to boost economic activity during downturns. Recent statements and analyses suggest a shift in Fed policy towards rate hikes, with some predicting multiple increases soon. This departure from previous expectations of rate cuts has prompted speculation about its economic effects. One perspective suggests that higher interest rates could actually spur economic growth. The argument goes that increasing the cost of borrowing encourages responsible financial practices, prevents excessive risk-taking, and fosters a more stable economic environment in the long term. A more cautious perspective draws attention to the difficulties that higher interest rates may present in the short term. As the cost of borrowing increases, companies may limit their investments, and consumers may decrease their spending. This decrease in investment and spending could reduce economic activity, which could lead to an economic downturn or even a recession. Furthermore, there are concerns about the impact of rate hikes on various sectors of the economy. For example, higher mortgage rates could dampen demand for housing, leading to a decline in home sales and a downturn in the real estate market. Similarly, businesses reliant on cheap credit may struggle to finance operations, leading to layoffs and business closures. Evidence from recent trends adds weight to these concerns. Reports of prominent CEOs and investors liquidating stocks at record highs suggest a lack of confidence in the market's long-term prospects. Despite rhetoric about an economic boom, indicators such as store closures, layoffs, and bankruptcies paint a bleak picture of stability. In particular, the commercial real estate sector faces significant challenges, with rising defaults and foreclosures. The tightening credit environment, oversupply, and rising costs threaten to trigger a wave of distress in the market. The Federal Reserve's interest rate hike. The Federal Reserve, often called the Fed, plays a crucial role in the U.S. economy. Its primary responsibility is to manage the country's monetary policy, which includes controlling the money supply in the economy. One of the most effective tools at its disposal is the ability to influence interest rates. In response to economic conditions, the Fed has hiked interest rates 11 times between March 2022 and January 2024. These increases aim to curb rampant inflation by making borrowing more expensive for banks, businesses, and individuals. This move was aimed at containing rampant inflationary forces and maintaining maximum employment levels, all while steering the economy out of recession. However, like a double-edged sword, this decision can inflict collateral damage on the very economy it was meant to protect. The Federal Reserve has tightened the availability of credit by increasing borrowing costs. This could negatively impact economic growth by making it more difficult for consumers and businesses to access the credit they need. As a result of limited credit availability, investment may slow down, consumer spending could decrease, and ultimately, economic activity may come to a halt. In addition, it is important to note that the consequences of the increase in interest rates are not limited to the United States. The interconnected global economy means that the effects of the Federal Reserve's actions are being experienced worldwide. This includes the impact on international trade, currency values, and other related factors. The Great Billionaire Sell-Off. Recently, several high-profile business leaders have been offloading their company stocks. For example, Jeff Bezos recently sold Amazon shares worth $8.5 billion. Jamie Dimon, who is the CEO and chairman of JPMorgan Chase, sold $150 million worth of stock, and Mark Zuckerberg unloaded approximately 1.4 million shares of Meta stock worth around $638 million. The recent sales made by billionaires have caused concern and raised questions about the current state of the economy. It seems that a significant shift is happening in the financial world, as these individuals are selling their shares in companies at an unprecedented rate. These billionaires have achieved their fortunes through wise financial decisions and a keen eye for opportunities, and their current actions suggest that they are taking decisive action in response to current market conditions. The recent trend of billionaires selling off their assets is not a coincidence or a temporary phenomenon. It clearly indicates their lack of confidence in the current economic climate and a warning of the problems that lie ahead. By liquidating their holdings, these billionaires are signaling to the markets that they should prepare for the coming storm and take necessary measures to weather it. The consequences of this sell-off are not limited to the financial elite. When the world's richest individuals, who have access to the most advanced economic data and forecasting tools, make such a significant decision, its effect ripples throughout the entire economic system. The causes of economic woes. Although the Federal Reserve's decision to increase interest rates may have contributed to the current economic crisis, the root causes of this problem are much more intricate and ingrained. The economy's poor condition can be traced back to a combination of various economic issues that have worsened each other, creating an unfavorable cycle that could escalate and become even more challenging to manage. Inflation has been a persistent problem for the economy, despite the Federal Reserve's efforts to address it by raising interest rates. It has eroded the purchasing power of both consumers and businesses, resulting in higher prices for essential goods and services. As a result, many households have had to cut back on their spending and tighten their belts. Rapid economic growth can lead to inflation if it outstrips the economy's productive capacity and creates resource shortages. In such situations, the Federal Reserve may increase interest rates to slow down the economy's growth rate and prevent inflation from spiraling out of control. The state of the labor market can also impact interest rates. When unemployment is low, competition for workers increases, which can drive up wages. Higher wages can result in increased spending, leading to higher demand and prices and inflation. To manage inflation, the Fed can increase interest rates, which can help to cool down the labor market. Global economic factors can also play a part. If other major economies raise their interest rates, it could attract investors seeking higher returns, leading to a flow of capital out of the US and an economic slowdown. To prevent this, the Fed might increase interest rates to stop the capital outflow. At the same time, supply chain disruptions, labor shortages, and geopolitical tensions have all contributed to a slowdown in economic activity, interfering with the ability of businesses to meet consumer demand and limiting their growth. The consequences of the economic woes. The impact of the ongoing crisis is not limited only to the ultra-wealthy or financial elite, but it has far-reaching effects on the broader economy. It can affect everyone, from the small businesses lining Main Street to the towering skyscrapers of Wall Street. No sector is immune to the fallout. Small businesses are especially at risk due to rising costs, decreased consumer spending, and tighter credit conditions. This economic downturn has created a challenging situation for small businesses, many of which are struggling to stay open. They are forced to make tough decisions about staffing, inventory, and even their long-term viability. In the corporate world, the impact is no less severe. Major companies are struggling with the prospect of slowing growth, diminishing profit margins, and the need to streamline operations to weather the storm. This, in turn, has implications for employment, investment, and the economy's overall health. The imminent recession. As economic uncertainty grows, there are concerns that a severe recession may be on the horizon. Both economists and financial analysts are warning that the combined effect of these factors could lead to a deep and long-lasting economic downturn. The repercussions of such a recession would be significant and far-reaching. Job losses, business closures, and a decline in economic activity would have a terrible effect across all sectors, impacting everything from housing markets to consumer confidence and more. Furthermore, the impact of an economic downturn would extend beyond national borders, affecting global trade, investments, and overall financial stability. The path forward. Given the current challenges, it's clear that we need to take bold and decisive action to get the economy back on track. However, the path ahead is full of uncertainty and difficult decisions. Some argue that the Federal Reserve should continue to raise interest rates to control inflation. However, this approach risks worsening the economic slowdown and causing the recession it's trying to prevent. Some people suggest that the Federal Reserve should adopt a more cautious approach by putting a hold on rate hikes. This would give the economy enough time to recover and adjust. However, this approach could be perceived as a sign of vulnerability and have an adverse effect on the public's confidence in the Fed's ability to manage the crisis. In reality, the most effective solution to the current economic situation may involve a comprehensive approach that combines monetary policy with fiscal measures, regulatory reforms, and a coordinated effort to address the underlying structural issues that have contributed to the poor state of the economy. The decision made by the Federal Reserve to increase interest rates has set in motion a chain of events that can upset the delicate balance of the global economy. The exit of influential billionaires and institutional investors, coupled with the already weak state of the economy and the looming threat of a severe recession, has cast a pessimistic shadow over the economy. In these uncertain times, it is evident that we need to take bold and decisive action to guide the economy back on track. To tackle the challenges ahead, policymakers, business leaders, and consumers must remain vigilant and adaptable. By working together, embracing innovation, and fostering resilience, we can overcome this crisis and emerge stronger on the other side.